स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू श्री सिद्ध विद्यापीठ स्कूल। आई होप यू ऑल डूइंग गुड एंड स्टेइंग सेफ फ्रॉम दिस कोविड-19। सो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सॉल्व द क्वेश्चन एंड आंसर्स ऑफ द पोएम वांट बाय सिल्विया स्टल्ट्स। इन द लास्ट वीडियो वी रेड द पोएम। हमें पता चला कि कैसे हम अपने नेचर को डिस्ट्रॉय कर रहे हैं, हाउ वी ह्यूमन बींग्स आर डिस्ट्रॉइंग आवर नेचर, हाउ वी हैव टू कंजर्व आवर नेचर, हम किस तरीके से नेचर को कंजर्व कर सकते हैं। पोएट ने हमें उस पोएम के ज़रिए ये बताया गया कि कैसे पास्ट में नेचर था और प्रेजेंट में कैसे नेचर हो गया है। पास्ट में नेचर बहुत ही सुंदर था, ट्रीज पास्ट में नेचर पास्ट में नेचर बहुत ही ज़्यादा अच्छा था। दे वेर रिच नेचुरल रिसोर्सेस। पास्ट में ट्रीज से हमें फ्रेश एयर, फ्रेश ऑक्सीजन सब कुछ मिलती थी। और अब हम अगर स्काई देखेंगे तो वो पूरी पोल्यूशन से भर गई है, वो अभी हेजी हो गई है। हमें वी कांट इवन सी द स्टार्स प्रॉपरली बिकॉज ऑफ दिस पोल्यूशन। द स्टार्स गॉट हिडन स्मोक के वजह से, पोल्यूशन की वजह से स्टार्स स्काई में हिडन हो गई है। वो अभी और उतनी ब्राइटली शाइन नहीं करती है जितनी ब्राइटली वो पास्ट में शाइन किया करती थी। वाटर बॉडीज जो पहले इतने साफ दिखते थे वो भी एकदम मैली हो गई, एकदम गंदी हो गई है। क्यों? ड्यू टू द इंडस्ट्रीज एंड ऑल दिस कंपनीज वी ह्यूमन बींग्स आर रनिंग। इसकी वजह से पोल्यूशन रिवर्स और ओशंस को बहुत ज़्यादा इफेक्ट होती है, और ये सब से हमारी नेचर को बहुत ज़्यादा इफेक्ट होती है, हमारी पूरी एनवायरमेंट को बहुत ज़्यादा इफेक्ट होती है। द नेचुरल रिसोर्सेज आर गेटिंग मतलब ख़त्म हो रही है। द नेचुरल रिसोर्सेज आर गेटिंग टू देयर एक्सटेंट, मतलब वो सारे भी धीरे धीरे ये सब पोल्यूशन की वजह से कमते जा रहे हैं। अगर ओशंस गंदा रहेंगे तो कहाँ से हमें फिश वगैरह अच्छे मिलेंगे। दे आर गेटिंग पल्यूटेड, और अगर उस पल्यूटेड चीज़ों को खाएंगे तो वी ह्यूमन बींग्स आर गेटिंग हेल्थ इश्यूज एंड एवरीथिंग। सो वी हैव टू कंजर्व आवर एनवायरमेंट, एंड हाउ वी आर गोइंग टू कंजर्व दिस एनवायरमेंट, ऑल दिस थिंग्स पोएट टोल्ड अस इन हर पोएम। थ्रू हर पोएम पोएट कन्वेड her sentiments, how she is worried. Through a poem, poet told us about how we human beings are slowly destroying our environment, how we are recklessly doing the human activities through which the nature is totally getting destroyed, totally getting polluted, and it's getting to its extent. So we have to stop this. हमें इस सबको stop करना। तो यही सारी चीज़ें poet ने अपनी poem में बताई है। So let's start the question and answers of this poem. So students, use your prescribed textbook for better understanding, and see on page number 16. There you will find the reading comprehension right below the poem. So we're gonna start the question and answers. Answer these questions within 20 words each. What does the poet mean by the sands of time? By sands of time, the poet means the years that have passed by. Where would the birds chirp from? The birds would chirp from sights unseen. What does the poet ask us to plant? The poet asks us to plant a better seed by tearing out old roots, weeding and cultivating properly. Move on to next one. Answer these questions in 30 to 40 words each. Name two things that the poet feels. The poet feels the blue skies which are no longer clear. The stars which had been bright have now become dim, hidden by the haze of pollution. What has happened to the crystal clear waters of the ocean? The crystal clear waters of the oceans have turned brown. They are now littered as a result of pollution. The abundant fish and streaming rivers are now a thing of the past. What action should we take up now? We should now plant a better seed by tearing out all old roots. We should cultivate by removing all weeds that hamper growth. We should protect our water, skies, wildlife and trees. Move on to next one. Answer these questions in 8200 words each. How does the poet bring out the truth of the proverb, "You reap what you sow"? Give examples to support your answer. The poet brings out the truth of the proverb, you reap what you sow, by drawing a vivid picture of the environment as it stands today. Industrial development and urban lifestyles are largely responsible for the pollution that has affected the clear blue skies and dimmed the brightness of the shining stars. Our ocean floors have been littered and their crystal waters have turned brown. The birds that chirp from the sights unseen have vanished and the towering trees have been brought down to meet our needs for paper. We have not valued what has been bestowed on us by nature. On the contrary, we have abused what has been given and are now facing the consequences of our action. Second, the poet implies that we do not respect nature or its gifts to us. Do you agree? Justify your answer. I agree with the poet when she says that we do not respect nature or our gifts. We do not preserve what has been given to us in abundance. We do not take care of our natural resources, but we are responsible for the depletion of these resources through our own action. We waste paper, thus causing many trees to be cut down. We waste water and electricity, and we destroy the habitats of birds and animals to meet our requirements. We litter our surroundings, uncaring of the harm caused to the environment. Instead of planting more trees, conserving our birds and animals that are on the verge of extinction, we indulge in actions that are detrimental to the earth. Move on to next one. Read these lines and answer the questions that follow. Trees towered high above, trunks bearing professed love, birds chirping from sights unseen, gone paper joined pollution steam. What does the poet mean by trees bearing professed love? By trees towered high above, trunks bearing professed love, the poet means to say that trees express great love by providing us with all that we need. They give us shade to rest, fruits to eat, and wood to build our homes. What do you understand by the last two lines of the extract? The poet says that birds that used to chirp all around us have disappeared and the need for paper had destroyed the trees which sheltered these birds. Both pollution and paper are the reasons for the disappearance of trees and birds. What picture come to your mind on reading these lines? The picture that appears is one of bleakness and despair. One can neither see the lush green trees nor hear the cheerful chirping of birds. Second one. Protect what has been given for free, our water, skies, wildlife and trees. For once they are gone, don't you say, consider yourself warned of that fatal day. What is free? Natural resources like water and air have been given free. What does the poet mean by the fatal day? By fatal day, the poet means the day we will be deprived of all the natural resources and will have neither fresh air nor clean water to drink. Do you think that the poet is being unnecessarily anxious? Why not? I don't think the poet is being unnecessarily anxious because the earth's resources are diminishing at an alarming rate and will be completely destroyed if proper steps are not taken immediately. So students, here are the solutions of this poem Want. I hope you will learn it. Please fairly note it down in your class note copy. Please read this question and answers. I'm again telling, this is a wonderful poem. I want you all to read it thoroughly and learn the question answers briefly. If you have any doubts related to this poem, you can ask me. I'm going to clear it out in the next video. Thank you.